This is a postscript to a tape that was made some time before with Colonel Bernard Kellner, who told about the Oklahoma Infantry at an earlier date and also about teaching school in early days. But I wanted to add to this, Colonel Kellner, a little bit about your experience in athletics and how the athletics took place in the early days in the school. Why don't you talk about your experience there?
We may think that the interest in athletics and self-amusement is something originated in the last 5 years. This is not true. The same interest in athletics and self-amusement and playing together existed at the turn of the century that exists now. The environment was different, meaning that there was not the availability of equipment, the availability of trained people in athletics, or athletics was not as clearly organized as they are today, or in other words, it wasn't big business. It was simply for time-consuming and fraternization and visitation and care. And it divided in two parts, you might say. At school, we had recess and noon, and we played different kinds of athletics. Baseball, particularly, we always had a baseball team. There were three kinds of baseball. There was the one and two-man old cat, and then there was the anti-over. I will just tell you about the baseball. The baseball was the same as it is today and had certain rules, had the umpire. The umpire in those days stood behind the pitcher. In these country areas, if they had a baseball, a commercial baseball, and a good bat, they were way ahead. Usually they had to provide themselves with some kind of a stick or whittled out bat, or even in the case of a ball, wind up string and make a ball out of it. At this ball, they played baseball, as I said, like they do today. And the teacher had to teach them, and they taught themselves. In my district, in Visayas, Oklahoma, or near Visayas, about 8 miles from Visayas, Pioneer District number 55, we had more good fortune than most districts. A pioneer there was a Union soldier and thereby a pensioner, and he had money every month or every 3 months, whichever it may be, and he had grown sons that were athletes. So we were always fortunate in having at least one mitt and a regular baseball and a regular bat. Uniforms, nobody worried about that. They just had some clothing on. And in the summertime, of course, they didn't need any shoes. They went barefooted. And they had organized teams, schools did. And if they didn't have school teams, they would get on a location on Sunday afternoon in some cow pasture that was level enough and lay out a diamond and choose sides. They chose sides by taking a bat, and each one hand over hand, and the one that came out at the top got to choose the first member of his team. So then they alternated till they got their team, everybody on it, and went at it. Now, they had their difficulties there, just like they have now. They didn't believe the umpire knew what he was doing, and they threatened the umpire, and et cetera, like they do now.
We will turn over this tape for the next interview.